Hello, everyone. Welcome to another great episode of GWA Breakout. We've got a hell of a show here for you tonight. And, man, this is going to be an interesting one. Let's get things started, shall we? We're kicking things off with the Bogans, ladies and gentlemen. That is always an interesting way to kick things off here with GWA. They'll be taking on the Wolf Ray. This will be an interesting way to kick things off. The Bogans still winless here in GWA. They've been on that hell of a losing streak here. Now we've got some great other matches here. We're going to understand the champ's going to be here later on tonight. That's going to be great. Of course, we've got a hell of a main event for you too tonight's great six-man tag, as well as some great women's action. All the Bogans are going to be in action tonight. Even Barbie Bogan is going to be in action later on against Maxine Martinez. And here comes the Wolf Raid, ladies and gentlemen. Jake Raid, Lake Wolf. This is going to be an interesting battle. Going to be teaming up with newcomer Al Cabrera, who was doing some great commentary for us and is now a member of the active roster. And Matthew Stone is going to be making his in-ring debut for GWA also tonight. It's going to be interesting to see him. He's going to be taking on number one contender Joe Omega, who will be battling the champion Jack Cage at the upcoming Ashes match. And yeah, here it comes. Al Cabrera. We've got a great show for you tonight, ladies and gentlemen. GWA Breakout. And we are so close now to the Ashes. That's going to be great. All six of the men in our main event will be part of the Ashes tournament, which will be a one-night tournament in Brisbane at the Gabba. And that'll be a great. The winner of that tournament gets a title shot in the next CPV, which is yet to be named, ladies and gentlemen, so you want to keep close ties to everything that's going on. Especially GWA's move to 2K19, which is coming up much sooner than was expected. And Blake Wolf just kicking things off, going right after Johnny Bogan. Oh! Well, my understanding is Johnny Bogan might have a great look, but he's got terrible stamina. Oh! He loves lifting those weights, but he's not great. Great at the cardio. Oh, he's stepping on Blake Wolf's throat. Oh, that's just disrespectful. Blake Wolf now is getting beat down by the heavyweight of the Bogan, the big enforcer. Oh, I was just punching him in the face. He has a great physique, I gotta say that. This man, but he's... Oh! stretching that back. And Calvin Clutch trying to make him humble. A la the Iron Sheik, but like Wolf has got that athleticism. He's a great athlete. Oh, big suplex. Oh, I understand that the Wolf Raid got a choice of who they wanted their tag partner to be, and they went to Al Cabrera, which is really interesting. I understand that he's kind of started hanging out a bit, these three guys, and that might be getting along. There might be a forming of an alliance here. Oh, tosses him over the top rope. Oh, punch to the outside. Al Cabrera. Oh wait, Blake Wolf's willing to take it to the Bogans. Well, Jake Reid tosses Barry back in. Oh, here it is. Oops, bang, neck breaker. Here come... Oh, no. I thought they were going for their finish, but... Oh, just tosses across the body. Lock. Oh, and in comes Dave Bogan. Oh! Dave Bogan, the hairy Bogan. Oh! Big body slam! Never met a razor he liked. Oh, big leg drop. And big, wait a minute, big power slam that is off Dave Bogan. I wonder how excited he is for the upcoming Ashes tournament. I know that they're not, none of the Bogans are involved in it. Oh, beautiful clothesline, but they'll be involved in a six-man tag at the event. Oh, Jake Reid just took out all of them. Oh, big. Jake Reid, of course, the first guy to beat the Australian Dragon, who was on that hell of a winning streak to begin his career here in GWA. Oh, big backbreaker and Russian leg sweep. And in comes Al Cabrera. Oh! And Stan Al is kind of disappointed that he wasn't invited to the Ashes series. But, understand he was considered one of the... He was just a little bit out of it, just because of his late debut this month. Oh! Leading up to this. Oh, Barry's just come in. Tosses him into the ring. Another turnbuckle and... Oh! Just throws him. Here comes Johnny. Johnny Bogan. He was the first Bogan to make... Like, first member of the Bogan family to make his debut. Then he brought in his big brother. Oh! Barry, and oh, Al Cabrera's got a very distinct style, and oh, beautiful suplex, and it's another elbow drop there. So, oh wait, watch this maneuver, he twists his legs, and then drives him down, head first into the mat. Now he's going for that double underhook. Oh! What's he looking for here? Not sure, but... Oh, wait a minute. Airplane spin. Oh, neck breaker. decides to toss him into this. Oh, I think I know what he's planning. He's another crossbody. Seems to be the favorite move at the moment. Leg drop. I know what they're planning here. This is what they wanted. Springboard, the last Wolf Ray. Oh. He's dizzy. But man, I think Johnny's completely out of it. I think he is. 1, 2, 3. Wolf Raid and Al Cabrera win it. Now, that was a great way to kick things off here on this 24th episode of GWA Breakout. Oh, great highlights. Yeah, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that crossbody. And the Wolf Raid. And well, ladies and gentlemen, it's been a hell of a beginning of the show, but don't go anywhere because we'll be right back with more GWA action here. We've got plenty more to come. You don't want to miss it. There's your winners, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, here's a look at the bracket for the Ashes series. We've got Max Bell, Australian Dragon, AJ Cool, Wild Thing, Alex Hassan, Big Time, G.I. Bloke, and Dallas. This is what the tournament's going to look like for the Ashes, ladies and gentlemen. And I can't wait. We're getting word now. Here comes the champ. The champ's coming out. Some interesting words for us here, I'm sure. So I'll let him do the talking. Ooh, these are harsh words. Well, that's some harsh words from the champ, ladies and gentlemen, to Joe Omega, who seemed to think that it was going to be an easy pickings for him to get against the Beast from Newcastle. He seems to have really embraced that title. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen. Speaking of the challenger, ladies and gentlemen, here comes Joe Omega. One of the newest members of the roster here. This is going to be an interesting bout. He's going to be taking on another newcomer, Matthew Stone. Not sure the history between these two men, but I'm sure it'll be very interesting. Two newcomers. Man, Joe Omega looks pumped. I wonder if those words kind of got under the skin of Jack Cage there. But that was the sense of construction. Anyway, he's going to be taking on Matthew Stone. He's making his GWA debut tonight. Here comes Matthew Stone, who's looking to turn over a new leaf here in GWA. It's going to be very interesting. See what happens with him. I'm reaching out, I'm reaching out. I'm not a stranger to the danger. There's a wall that's going nowhere. In a world with you, especially here in GWA now. Looking to turn over that new leaf, looking to change his heart. So it's going to be very interesting to see what happens here. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Joe Omega. Oh! Matthew Stone. And it's not looking like starting off how Matthew Stone wanted it to come. And Joe's just beating the hell out of him. Oh, beautiful Russian leg sweep. Get things started here. Now, of course, Matthew Stone wants to win and prove that he's got some staying power here, but Joe Omega's going to want to win, especially after, oh my god, running Bulldog. What Jack Cage just said. I'm not sure he's... I think maybe the confidence and the fact that Jack Cage has been so successful here in GWA might be going to his head a bit. But, I mean, you can't argue with results. Oh, beautiful neck breaker. And now Matthew Stone going to the top rope now. And beautiful moonsault. Oh, slamming his elbow in him. Head and shoulder there, and now Matthew Stone looks like he's got the advantage now. Beautiful suplex. Oh, elbow drop. Now he's got the sleeper locked in. He's got it locked in now, and he really is looking to do some damage with it. Oh. But look at this. Beautiful. Just, you see why Joe Omega is the one of the premier athletes in all of virtual wrestling. And boom, elbow drop there. I mean, this ain't some schlub that Jack Cage is going to be taking on. This guy has done so much in all of virtual wrestling. Oh, strikes him. Wait a minute, and he's gone up top rope, and oh, knee to the back. Punches to the face, oh. Pulling back on the neck now. Just loving that submission hold. Really working his magic against Matthew Stone here. It might be a bit out of depth. I mean, this is Joe Omega, so. Oh, beautiful suplex. Matthew Stone now chops some beautiful strikes. And Michinoku driver type maneuver there. It's going right up to the top. We're going to fly again. Oh, beautiful elbow drop there. Matthew Stone. Well, he's looking in that sleeper again. They're bringing him down, which is really good. And you notice he's wrapping his legs around the midsection. That's trying to take some more oxygen out of him. See if it works. But same result again. Breaks out of it. And Joe Omega looking for Fisherman suplex. One, two, oh, not quite enough. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, that beautiful maneuver there, I've spaced on the name of it, but yeah, it's sit out pile driver, oh. And it's a one. And a two, and a three. Joe Omega wins. Very hard to get out of that sit-out pile driver. That is. That Fisherman Suplex does a great job defending. Look at this. Boom. It's all over after that move. Drives his head into the mat. That is not good, ladies and gentlemen. That is not good. This just shows that Joe Omega is ready for the Ashes. World title match, I mean. How appropriate is it that a man from Britain is going to be facing Australian for a world championship at the GABA and an event will be actually held for a trip. Ladies and gentlemen, you're right. Wait a minute. Oh my god! Look at this! And he's whacking Matthew Stone with a sledgehammer. Oh, right into the chest numerous times. Oh. Well, luckily Matthew Stone was able to walk out under his own power. I guess he didn't do quite as much damage as we thought, but I'm sure the doctors in the back are going to be checking up on him. But here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Big Time Outlaws coming out now, and we'll try and keep you updated with the condition of Matthew Stone. Paul, that was horrific, ladies and gentlemen. But here we go, the Big Time Outlaws, they're going to be taking on the Backyard Boys, who've been doing pretty well for themselves lately, so it'll be interesting to see what happens, especially against a top-tier team of this sort. Ladies and gentlemen, so... This is going to be a great matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Especially with the Ashes coming up. Bush Ranger Jack. Could be an interesting situation. He might be taking on Mike Landry for the Hardcore title. That was at least planned, but it might not happen now. Keep up to date with the Napoleon Norverse action to see what's happening with that. Some interesting stuff currently. And here come the Backyard Boys. Tim Richards. And Bobby Law. Backyard wrestlers extraordinaires. I can't escape this. So this is going to be an interesting matchup, ladies and gentlemen. I just know it. You got the high flyers, you got the brawler, and the big man. And Big Time. So this is going to be an interesting matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Very clashing of styles. Don't forget, ladies and gentlemen, we also have Maxine Martinez going up against Barbie Bogan next, and then we've got a huge six-man tag with six participants from the Ashes series also coming up there. Well, Big Time's going to be involved in that match as well, so kind of getting a preview of what you might see there as well. Dallas Holiday is going to be in that, but I understand he's back at home at his ranch in Texas. Oh! Probably doing some early voting there. I understand there's some midterm elections coming up there. Oh! Curious. Oh! Big elbow drop. There. Big Time starting things off here hard. Yeah, hammering her away there. And near the back of the head. And, oh, nice neck breaker. Working his magic here, trying to get that action in. Bush Ranger Jack. He's got to stay healthy, because if he's got that Norverse Hardcore title match coming up. I understand Mike Landry has a rematch scheduled sometime in the future. I don't know where. But yeah. Oh! Otherwise, it'll just be an ordinary hardcore match between the two, I understand. I'm just getting word from Edward Jones now that, like, no matter what, that match is taking place. It's just a matter of if it will be for the Norverse Hardcore title or not. Oh, and beautiful! Another, seems to be the popular move, double-team maneuver of the night. Just chuck your opponent, chuck your partner at your opponent. Oh! Oh, beautiful jawbreaker from Bobby Law there. Oh. Aussie Lord's going to the top rope now. He does like to fly. Oh, and a beautiful moonsault, ladies and gentlemen. Oh. Stranger Jack, we're going to get out of it. You can see Tim Richards at the apron. He's doing some heavy breathing there. He seems to be fine now, but he was breathing heavy there. He was it's taking quite a beating from him, big time, and Bush Ranger Jack. And now Bush Ranger Jack is stomping away on Bobby Law, trying to get the advantage going in for his partner, big time, when he comes thinking, oh, look, here's the outlaw combination. Oh. What do we got here? Oh. Oh. Big time with the boot. One. Two. Oh no. Just didn't work out for him there. Oh, big elbow drop. Oh, the wind up. Wind up big time elbow. And here comes a big time elbow drop. There it is. Oh, looks like Tim Richards is stuck on the outside. Oh, he's sliding in. Oh, just a bit too late. Wasn't able to stop it there. Oh. And that's the experience edge. Look, here's the double team maneuver. Oh. That big foot of. And then Tim Richards just rolls out of the outside. Not good at all. And here's one, two. But oh, kicks out, and I don't know why I'm showing that. It's a beautiful rollout, and there's a wind up elbow, and here's a big time elbow. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, that's a little preview of some of the action you might be seeing at the Ashes with these two men. Keep you up to date with all that's going on with the North vs. Hardcore title, of course, ladies and gentlemen. Future is indeed united, ladies and gentlemen. Now let's get things going with some women's action now, ladies and gentlemen. Maxine Martinez. It's been a hell of an addition to the roster, and it is definitely, I gotta say, it was probably one of the future women's champions here in GWA. I think it's a matter of when she wins that title. She's very good. So it'll be very interesting to see what happens there. Especially when you see her in the ring, ladies and gentlemen, you'll be just as entertained as I am. And here's Bobby Bogan, who took on Maxine Martinez at the first main event of GWA Dead Set, which was a little over 2 months ago. And that was the first main event, ladies and gentlemen, so that was very interesting. And it was actually the debut of Maxine Martinez as well that night, so. And these two have clashed a couple of times, and usually Maxine Martinez has been on the winning side, which I'm sure has surprised a lot of you, so it will be very interesting. Has Bobby Bogan learnt some of the tricks of Maxine Martinez, or... could it be all a little bit different now? Oh, look at that. Look at the arrogance of Bobby Bogan. But they shake hands. Maybe there's a bit of respect that has developed between these two. I don't know. Oh, man. Maxine Martinez. She's a great expert in that Lucha Libre style. Isolating her in the corner. Look, springboard, crossbody. Oh. Just already working her magic here. Oh, look at that. She dabbed. Oh, my God. She's stretching her out here. Oh, look. Thank God for that position. I hope she's not flying commando tonight. Barbie, I hope she hasn't. No one wants to see that. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, drop kick to the knee. Probably looking to take the legs away from Maxine, trying to take that airborne style away from her. Punches in the face now, and oh, look at this. Oh, she's gonna stretch her out here. Oh, that puts to the back and just stretches out your arms, your shoulders, and which was to take it back. It's not very good. Oh, kick to the back. And wait a minute, drop toe hold. And oh, camel clutch. She's trying to make her humble. Oh, stretching her out. And oh. It's been beautiful. And. And what a beautiful suplex. Oh, what a moonsault. Standing moonsault. Oh, she's going for it again. Dusting her feet off, and there she goes. Kick to the back now. What's she planning? Oh, the maximizer. Could it be? Oh. Could be setting up the maximizer here. Oh! That jacks your whole head. One, two, three. Maxine Martinez. Does it there. Picks up another victory here. Right. Going in. Oh, look at that. Oh. That's brutal. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what time it is? It's main event time. Coming up next, ladies and gentlemen, so don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Six-man tag team action. Start the show off with it, and we're going to end the show with it. What a great action, ladies and gentlemen. So, be right back with you. We're back, ladies and gentlemen, and here it comes, AJ Cool. You know what, I bet you he's looking forward to the tournament because he wants another shot at the GWA World Champion. He wants that another shot at him, he thinks he can beat him. And, well, you gotta say he came close a couple of times during that Last Man Standing match at Ultimate Crisis. Oh yeah, I think he's justified in being part of this tournament. So yeah, it's going to be very interesting. I mean, he took Jack Cage to his limit in that match, and by the way, I think Jack Cage took AJ Cool to his limit. Put him to a level that he hasn't been to very many times, at least. But yeah, AJ Cool, the Anarchist. Looking to make an impact here tonight. On the way to GWA The Ashes. Here is Alex Asan. Oh, he dabs. Well, I hope they have the contract GWL and GWA keeps going, because man, it's a situation. Going forward, so here to the top rope is Alex Asan. Well, here we go. He had a title shot too, and now I'm betting he wants another chance at it as well. And here's Max Bell. Max Bell, he was put in this tournament by Edward Jones, who sees a lot of potential in him, but says he hopes he takes advantage of that opportunity, so that'll be very interesting. Going forward, and yeah, it's going to be very interesting. Recently had a title shot against the Australian champion, Aussie Andy, who we're going to hear from at Dead Set, which is coming up soon. They're of course over in Brazil doing their bit, getting ready for the wrestling carnival. So yeah, and here comes the Australian Dragon, who I'm sure is going to do very well in that tournament. He could be one of the favorites going into that tournament. So yeah, this is going to be very interesting. I mean, you can't take away the high-flyingness of the Australian Dragon. He's probably the best high-flyer in all of GWA and one of the best in all the virtual wrestling. Pulls stuff out of nowhere. It's incredibly accurate. Style. Inspired by people like Ultimate Dragon, Daniel Bryan. Various others. Jushin Thunder Liger. Lots of the Japanese and Lucha Libre stars. And here comes probably the favorite to win the whole Ashes tournament. Wild Thing. I mean, you look at the size of him, you look at his experience here in GWA. Very rarely, except for recently with Alex Sanchez, he's been on his back. He's been doing very well for himself here, and I gotta say, it's been great to see him rise here so well. And yeah, he showed up and did very well for himself. Very strong, powerful. You can clearly see his influences. But yeah, Wild Thing has done very well for himself here in GWA. So it'll be interesting to see what happens with him at the Ashes tournament. So he's got to be one of the favorites, if not the favorite, to win the whole thing. And this is an interesting pick. He was GI bloke. I don't know. He could, honestly, he's got the strength, he's got the power, but the experience. And we haven't seen him go too long, so he's probably the bottom pick to win the tournament. But I don't know. He could be the dark horse in that tournament. So I don't know. This is going to be very interesting in that thing is going on. He's only just debuted. He's got a lot of wrestling experience, pro wrestling experience, so it'll be very interesting to see how well he does. I mean, he's facing Dallas Holliday, who's been on a hell of a winning streak. He's done very well for himself, but we're kicking things off with the Australian Dragon and AJ Cole, so this is a good way to start things off here. Oh, beautiful drop kick to the face. So we're going to get a little bit of a taste here for what's going to be happening in the Ashes tournament, ladies and gentlemen. So this will be very interesting. Oh, Australian Dragon takes out the AJ Cool's partner. So yeah, this is going to be very cool. Wait a minute, roll through. And, down. Pulls him up, and yeah, this is not good. Oh, he's trying to make him humble. Oh, trips him up there. Oh, punches to the face. Oh, wait, big body slam. Oh, yeah, wouldn't expect this. These athletes are they're very small, but they do very well for themselves. Oh, and, oh, jeez. Oh. The back. Punches to the face, uppercut now. Roll through. This really get it. Yeah, he's too close to the ropes. That happens quite a bit with AJ Cole. He rolls through and then all of a sudden he's at the ropes. It's like he doesn't realize how well that works out for him. Well, that works out for him. Now he's put him in that modified camel clutch now. Working a hell of a lot against the Australian Dragon. It's not good. I mean, beautiful big body slam. Oh, wait a minute. Up to the top right now. Oh, beautiful elbow drop. Basic. Oh my god. Springboard. Moonsault from the top rope. And now another moonsault. Oh, working their magic on AJ Cool now. Tosses him into the corner. Who are they bringing in now? Oh, Oh no, my god! Oh god, what a cross body from the top rope by Wild Thing. This is not good, ladies and gentlemen. Oh! Jeez. Punches to the face. AJ cool now. Toss him into the corner. Bringing in Max Bell. What are they doing there? Spinning there. Kicks to the gut. Kicks to the back. Oh. So we've taken the high flyer out and brought in the amateur wrestling All-American here. Oh! Suplex. What a Wild Thing. Oh! Wild Thing is really... Oh my god. Wild Line. Oh! Oh my god, no, 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 no. I know what he's going through. Wild Bomb. Oh! One, two, oh! The shoulder up there, stomping away now. He's gonna put him in the corner again. No, wait, Max Bell's making a comeback here. Oh my god, what a beautiful suplex. Now the top second rope. Well, things better about it. So, against, brings in Alex Hassan, who's got a hell of a record against Wild Thing here, is one of the few people to beat him consistently. Oh, another suplex. Oh my god. Macy can pick that man up. Oh, and in comes G.I. Blow. Oh, flip through DDT. Oh my god. Elbow drop. Oh, fist to the face. Oh my god, no, he's picking him up, he's picking him up. Oh! Beautiful. Modified stun gun there. Oh, working his magic on the knees now. The knees. G.I. Bloke. Oh! Picks him up and puts him down over that beautiful belly-to-belly suplex. Oh! Oh, yeah, beautiful rain clothesline. It's what he's good at. Wild Thing's coming in and brought a knee to the back, and oh. Oh, takes AJ Cole to the rope. And now he's picked him up. Oh, we got a series of. This is what he usually does, a series of suplexes. Backdrop suplex. German suplex. And now he goes for the standard vertical suplex. Oh. What's he setting up for here? Here it is, the last post, ladies and gentlemen. Oh! I'm going to carry into a powerbomb. One, two. Oh, Max Bell breaks it up. Bell tossed to the outside now. What could be going on here? Like Sun. Put into the corner and now he's going for another stun gun. Oh! Punches to the face. Oh, beautiful kick. Arson Cutter. Oh. Going for the pin. One, two. Oh, he kicks out. matches in there. Brings him down. What's he thinking here now? Drop kick to the head. Standing up over him. Wild Thing now comes in with a suplex of his own. Wild Thing in now. Looking for some payback. Oh, stomps to Alex's son. Max Bell, who was around the back brawling with Wild Thing, I think. And big body slam. Oh wait, now only a Strange Dragon back. Drop kick. Beautiful Hurricane Rana. He's in the back now. Draping. Oh, beautiful Enziguri. He's going up top. The Dragon Ball. Going for the pin. One, two, three. Oh, that's three. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I was a bit too quick there. Oh my god, that was beautiful matchup, ladies and gentlemen. Let's see some of those replays. There's the Wild Bomb. That's the end of the series of suplexes by G.I. Blow. And there's the last post. That's a running, shining wizard type maneuver. The Arson Cutter. That's all the replays we've got. Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, I didn't get to see the Dragon Ball again. But man, that was a great match, ladies and gentlemen. And we'll see you at Dead Set, and then it's the Ash, ladies and gentlemen. So thank you for listening and being along with us. We'll catch you at Dead Set soon, ladies and gentlemen.